Welcome everyone to the final interaction session of this FDP. So the hand raises, so I had seen around seven remote centers who had some questions. So the format of this session will still be the same. So we will get feedback from you. So what is one takeaway, like what Professor Sahanamurthy did in the previous session, you will have to tell me one takeaway that you have from this workshop. And so if there is a question, you should pose that question so that I can collect feedback from the other remote centers. So first I will go to Loyola ICAM RC1228.
Good evening, Mr. Jayakrishnan.
Yeah, good evening, sir.
Actually during the peer review, we have been waiting for quite some time to ask this question. Will be some background bias. What I mean by that is, like TQM say is a common subject, but when a mechanical engineer handles, he will have a different perception, and maybe if he is going to assess a civil engineering chap, so he will assess based on his mechanical engineering background. So how can we overcome this? And regarding the benefits you asked, like we had been out of common sense doing these activities, which we have come across now. But now after this, these sessions, it may become formalized and it will be structured. That's the advantage.
Okay.
Thank you. That's it.
Were there any open questions in the previous session that you want to answer? So I understand that several participants had raised queries. So do you have some answers or do you have some alternate suggestions for any of the questions that were raised by other remote centers, which you think there is some alternate solution?
Actually today morning, one of our participants from Tamil Nadu, I think in Salem, instead of giving their WordPress page, they gave away their login page. In case I'm going to assess the phone, which is asking that ID and password, in such a case, I am unable to open that PPT what they presented. Here the problem is, what is that? And the people, instead of giving their page, they are giving that login page. That's before posting that one, they have to see whether what link they are posting. That is the issue. And one thing, says that, suppose I belongs to management studies. I'm getting something from ECE or a civil department. I am not having a sufficient knowledge over that particular subject, something like in RCA 2. In such a case, what I have to do?
Okay. I'll answer the question finally. I'll ask other remote centers also to answer this question. So the questions from RC1228 is, it may so happen that in this FDP, since it's a generic FDP, a person from civil engineering will get somebody else's assignment, which may not be from civil engineering, or it could be from mechanical or electrical. So a problem is that they may not have domain knowledge to completely assess it. And the second problem, it may so happen that there could be some common subjects for multiple departments. So for example, the example that was said was total quality management, TQM, a teacher from a management domain and a teacher from a mechanical domain, both of them actually deals with the same subject, but their understanding of this particular concept is, their perspectives are different. It's not the understanding, the perspectives are different. So in this case, how will you evaluate the submission? So this is one question that has been raised from the center, RC1228. I'll be answering the procedural part of the questions like incorrect peer review and other things toward the end of this interaction session. But thank you, RC1228. So one important feedback that was given by RC1228 is that many of the teachers were actually doing many of these practices in an informal way earlier, which I think many of you would also agree. And this workshop has actually exposed them to the more formal or the systematic manner in which this can be done. So currently, I forgot to mention, currently I am at RC1002, Amal Jyoti College in Kerala. So the RC has been kind enough to provide me a venue at such a short notice. I thank the coordinators and the participants for providing me this opportunity. So I'll ask question first over here. You can individually think about it, then pair and discuss and provide me with an answer. So the question is, how will you overcome either the domain bias or the domain lack of domain knowledge while evaluating your peers' submissions? So you have already done RCA2 or RCA1 also, where you would have encountered this. You can individually think about it, discuss among yourselves, and I would also request other RCs to think about this question. And if you have an answer, you can raise your hand. I'll come to your remote center shortly.
Sir, I have one more suggestion also.
Okay.
So regarding that, training the people on how they have to review that one, you are giving one sample, what is that link, based on that, yes, people have to evaluate. Instead of that, you can test their level of knowledge in assessing their, how they have understood the rubrics, something like a multiple choice questions based on the rubrics. It may provide a clear understanding to the evaluator what they have understood from the particular topic. Maybe sometimes they may skip the PPT or the link what you have provided. But in case of MCQ type of questions, it may allow the people to think over that what you have prescribed in the rubrics. It may increase their level of knowledge in evaluating, that is the peer evaluation. That is my suggestion.
So what you are actually suggesting is, so the suggestion from RC1228, sir, can I know your name?
Selvaraj.
Okay, so the suggestion by Professor Selvaraj, I'll repeat the suggestion, correct me if I am wrong. So the suggestion is that before actually starting with the peer assessment, it would be better if we have an LBD on the rubric. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
So one request that I have for all the faculty who are actually viewing me right now, do not say MCQs from here onwards. You should focus on the verb learn by doing.
Yes,
so
sir.
This in itself will provide that required attitude shift, where you will know that these questions have to be practiced, it has to be done, and there is some learning that has to come out of it. So I would sincerely request all of you to formally accept the term learning by doing instead of MCQ whenever you start preparing exam questions or internal assessment questions in your own practice. Is that okay, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See you, sir. Definitely.
Yeah. Thank you, RC1228. Thank you for the feedback, and thank you for that great open-ended question that you had. So the question is, how to remove domain bias or lack of domain knowledge? How to handle the lack of domain knowledge while doing peer review? So this question is still open. Let me now go to RC, RVR and JC College.
The first part is about the takeaway from FDP, which was asked to be answered by the RC.
Yes.
All the participants of this RC are very pleased with the way the entire FDP was conducted. And we have learned a number of techniques, which include all like think pair share, team pair solo, and all those things. Particularly the flipped classroom activity and others. And as it is well said, other participants, we have now learned the structured way of doing the activity, and we are all trying to implement it in our regular teaching learning practice so that our students get the benefit. So we are very thankful to IIT Bombay X for conducting such a wonderful FDP. And now coming to the questions which other RCs have asked. One of the RCs have asked about how to deviate the students from exam orientation towards the learning of technology. Now, we thought examination is very important from the point of students, and therefore definitely they'll be eager to get more marks in the examination, so their concentration will be on examination preparation. So what we can do is we can walk along with them take the questions from the university exam papers and identify the topics and prepare the lesson plan, integrating the technology which we have learned, so that even the slow learners can pick up the content of the topic and use it for the preparation of examination. So this probably will motivate the students, and once they start getting benefit in terms of marks, they will slowly get aligned to the use of technology in their regular learning process. And one of the other RCs asked about the program objectives 6 to 12, like how we can design activities for program objectives 6 to 12 that are prescribed by the NBA. And we in our college have several ways of meeting these requirements. Like we have clubs which promote different skills in the students, and we observe different days, like say for example Engineers Day, when we make the students more motivated for societal issues, give them opportunities to go into the society and identify the problems, and that is how they become more society oriented and socially responsible individuals. And for this we can also have some kind of assessment and some incentive to the students in the form of internal marks. That is how we are doing it, sir. And similarly for promoting ethics, that is social responsibility, we conduct certain activities, and now as we are acquainted with ICT, we can align these technologies to promote professional ethics. Like we all teach the topic challenger disaster, then as you know, the students when they learn the topic under think pair share, they're able to understand it better. So this is one suggestion which we thought we can do. And similarly, communication skills also can be improved through the use of ICT. That's what we have been doing. And one of the colleagues was talking about usage of Padlet. And in our college, we are mostly using Moodle to get the same benefits that can be obtained using Padlet. And hereafter, we will also try to use Padlet. And coming to the domain bias, I think domain bias can be overcome with a little more patience and inclination to know what has been presented in the submission that has been made by the participant. See, when we make a conscious effort to know something, definitely I think at this level of knowledge which we all have, nothing I think remains gray. So we can definitely make out whether it is relevant or not. And what I find personally is that the rubrics has nothing to do with the content. You are only asking us to check whether the videos are of proper length or not, whether the terminology used is appropriate, that is it reflecting the lower level of thinking or higher level of thinking. I think we are testing only these things. For this, I don't think the domain comes as a barrier. So, but still if domain is a barrier, and if still the peer reviewer thinks that he or she cannot do, better they can put it to the e-outreach team and express their unwillingness to review. And also one more suggestion is that probably you can do it from this from your end, like unless the reviewer gives comment under each box, do not allow the reviewer to go to the next. Now what happens is that the first four, they are leaving it as blank, and at the end they're giving a very satirical comment, say that you make improvement. Now I don't understand as to how I improve unless my defects have been pointed out. So I wish that the peer reviewer must be advised and strictly follow that at the end of each parameter or segment evaluated, give your comment. Without that, the peer reviewer should not go to the next segment. This is what I think the IIT Bombay X can do. And I think this is all from my remote center. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, can I know your name, ma'am?
Dr. Shobha.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. All the points are valid. Additionally, do you have any questions to give ask the other participants?
Participants, like questions, right now I don't think we have very serious questions, but all the participants are concerned with their evaluation. So everybody is waiting for you to come over and take over, and everybody is interested in their scores. So probably you can help all of us with a very reasonable way of, you know, normalizing the scores. Because I want to make a mention here, sir. Dr. Patak in the morning was saying that he wants an army of, you know, mentors. And from our RC, everybody is willing to become a mentor, but I think we will not get a chance with the kind of peer reviewing which is going on now. So please rectify the peer reviewing process so that all of us will join your, I mean, strengthen your hands in reaching out to 350,000 educators of this great country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. So the immediate answer that for RC 1228, it's actually threefold answer that has been said by RC 1353. I would encourage participants from 1228 to actually go through the answer once more, and you can further interact with RC 1353 through chat and clarify if you have any more queries regarding it. And I hope that ma'am will be gracious enough to answer your additional doubts regarding this. Isn't it, ma'am?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. So the generic answer is that the rubrics are very generic, so it does not actually deal with subject complexity. The second was, if you have an inclination to learn, nothing is impossible. And the third is actually a very valid suggestion for us. We will try to make feedback mandatory for all the criteria, at least in OER for sure. For each and every category, we'll ensure that the feedback is made mandatory. So let me now move to the next RC 1140, Shastra University. General feedback about the FDP, specific feedback that you have, and if you have any answers to the earlier question, please go ahead.
Yes, sir. So regarding the resource creation assessment, we want to discuss, sir. So two things is, only the three criteria
I'm going to address towards the end of this interaction.
Okay, sir.
So once the all the queries are getting handled, we'll address the procedural part of it.
Okay, sir. How we can represent ourselves regarding the peer assessment? At the end, you will give the suggestions, no, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay, sir. Only regarding the RCA 01, sir. From
exactly.
Our side. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So all the procedural aspect of it, I'll take care towards the end of the session. Let me now move to RC 1026, St. Xavier's Catholic.
First, I'd like to give a feedback. So I'm most of us are aware of teaching through technology and MOOCs and all those things, but we never thought that we could implement in our own. Happy to say that we ourselves have started doing it, and we have done it in our institutions. Our students are able to make use of MASU open online courses which are developed by us. And the second thing is that even though we have certain issues in implementing this in our regular curriculum, we have found ways to make use of it. For example, this thing, teaching through a virtual world, is very effective when we are training our students for placement and other things. So I have a couple of questions, sir. First one has something to do with the last date for the submission of OERs. So when is the last date, sir?
So all the procedural questions, I'll address it, because I understand that the OER feedback form is still active. Please do not worry about due dates. We'll give you sufficient time to complete OER.
And the second thing is, I would like to answer a question that was generated in the previous session. And one of the participants from another resource center asked this question, what to do to make students watch videos. What I have observed in my classroom is that if the video is less than 5 minutes, the students don't have much issues. And there should be an option to provide the videos through WhatsApp too. So if it is a less than five minute video, then through WhatsApp, they watch it. They do not have much issues. Only when it crosses 5 minutes limit to 10 minutes limit, there's an issue. And that has been addressed in the previous assignment too, I think so.
Thank you for the solution. So this one new solution that you have provided is share the videos in WhatsApp group. I think many of the other participants may also agree to what you are saying. I think among the cohorts itself, WhatsApp is becoming more popular. compared to the other traditional mechanisms like discussion forum and other things. Are there any other open questions from your side, sir?
No, so that is it.
Okay, great. Thank you, RC1026, for the positive feedback that you have provided. We will address the procedural aspect of OER and other assignments once this interaction, towards the end of this interaction. So let me now go to the next RC, RC1190, Symbiosis Institute, Pune.
Good afternoon, sir. My name is Krishna Kant. I'm from Symbiosis. I have two queries. Query number one, sir, the rubric what you provide, there's a suggestion. Now, instead of rubric, is it possible to create something like whether the output is acceptable, not acceptable, or some improvement is required? Instead of giving marks, that is my question number one. Now, question number two I have with RAC2. Now, RAC2, if you see the construct, RCA2, if you see the constructor, what you have provided, so there are lots of slides, around 5-6 slides related to in classroom activity. But when we see the rubric, there is no marks allotted for this in class activity. Is there any way we can, because so we are spending time on that.
Okay.
Is there any justice for that?
Okay, I think I gave the justification yesterday also. So in-class activity, there will be a lot of, the in-class activity will now depend on the subject. So you need a lot more domain knowledge if you want to actually evaluate RCA2. And since RCA2 is an open-ended assignment, we cannot have a generic rubric covering in-class activity.
I'll just translate.
Yeah, so can you also tell me a feedback about the entire workshop if you have a generic feedback about the workshop?
It was amazing, sir. I've already started applying these techniques to my students. So learning is fantastic. I mean, I can also tell you that I have been with other members also, and it's fantastic. Only thing is that the moment we find that grading thing about the peer review grading, there we have some disappointment, but that we can understand. It's always subjective, and we can together we can improve this.
Yeah, so and you have any other open questions from your own practice that you want to ask the other RC members to answer?
Just one very important question regarding AVIEW sessions. Now, the question is, let's say if I, like today morning only, explain very detailed about peer review process and everything. Now, let's say if someone is not attending, is there any mechanism that you can find out those who are not attending cannot be a part of peer review process? Is there any mechanism from your side? That is one thing I just want to ask, I mean, IIT or all my colleagues, or do they think that this is valid, the point is valid or not?
I know it's okay, so you are asking, is there a mechanism to monitor AVIEW participation?
Yes. In peer review process.
Right. Monitoring AVIEW participation from IIT Bombay side, correct?
From IIT Bombay side, and then allocate those people, those who are attending AVIEW, for peer review. Not all.
Okay. This is a procedural question. I think I'll take it towards the end and answer regarding the general MOOC practice. So towards around 5:15, I'll be explaining to you the standard process that is followed at IIT when these kind of MOOCs, a blended MOOC, is offered. But I thank you for the positive feedback that you have provided, and I believe that you will be continuing a lot of these practices at your own place, and you will have a lot more colleagues also taking up these kind of practices, and you will have a community within your college, within your institution, doing this more in a sustained manner.
And sir, we have another query. Just wait for a moment.
Sir, for RCA2, it is required that if the video length is greater than 10 minutes, we need to cut that video. And my experience is, even for the RCA1 as well, cutting the video is a highly skillful job, because whatever software you are using for cutting the video, at the end, you ended up with a large file size. I would like to ask this question to even all other RCs, if they have any solution for this. Last time from IIT Bombay, solution you given is reduce the bit rate. That has also been tried, but still the file ended up with a 2 GB after cutting the video. Whereas the original size is only 30 MB.
Okay.
Now the question is, for RCA2, is it mandatory to cut the video?
Okay, so first of all, it is not mandatory that you have to do a edit in the video. You can just give the instruction that watch from this minute to this minute. But this is a valid question. So the original question that the participant has asked is, while doing video editing, they have found that the even with lower bit rates, the size of the video is pretty huge. So is there a mechanism that any other participant from any other RC has found so that the total overall file size becomes less? So I am keeping this question in the open, and thank you RC1190 for the valuable feedback that you have provided. I'll now move to the next RC1069.
Sir, actually we are eagerly awaiting for the OER clarifications, but I think we are expecting only feedback as of now.
Okay.
Yes, sir, we are indeed enjoying the FDP. Knowledge quiz this time is quite different from the first FDP. Difficult to guess because it is all multiple answers. It was a task for us, but still we were able to do it. And RC2 also was successfully done, but we are more bothered about the OER. We need more clarity because we are planning the different assignments which you have given us. We just want to know that, do we get a format, like one format what you have sent is the quiz in Moodle. But we are planning for some other one. Can we get a sample of other things also so that we plan appropriately?
Thank you for the feedback. I will have partially addressed your final query. So one thing that you can actually do is you can go and visit your mentor's WordPress webpage. All the mentors have created OERs in the last edition of this FDP. You can use those as samples. So you can ask the mentors if they can get other. So all the mentors' WordPress web pages given in FDP 101. What I'll do is I'll do one more copy paste in the FDP 201 course material so that all the participants will be benefited. Once again, thank you RC1069 for the feedback. I will address all the procedural queries regarding RCA and OER towards the end of this session. Thank you.
Yeah.
Let me now go to RC1263, Techno India, Salt Lake, Kolkata.
Yeah, the first question relates to the marking of the lab activity 2. Although we have done the lab activity, there is no marking.
Okay, the procedural part of it will come towards the end. Can you focus on the initial part of the goal of this session? The feedback about this FDP and questions, if you have any, for other RCs.
Normally, this is a very good FDP. We are learning a lot. But as far as the peer review sessions are concerned, we had some queries, but they have been already posed or answered by other RCs. So right now, we don't have any questions for that part. We have one more issue regarding the AVIEW sessions. That is, we would like the AVIEW sessions to be more interactive and full of activity, that is.
AVIEW sessions of the mentor or AVIEW sessions of IIT?
IIT.
Okay, great. So I'll definitely try to incorporate more interactive sessions in the upcoming interactions that are going to happen in future. But I, so regarding the peer review, as I said, and about the lab assignment, so the I know that all of you have done the Wiki Spaces activity, but the questions and other things will be released in due course of time, which you can attempt at the end of RC activity. So those will be released in due course of time. Okay,
sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you RC1263 for the feedback. Let me now go to another RC, RC1146, Knowledge Institute of Technology, Salem.
Sir, first of all, we would like to thank the IIT Bombay to provide such an interactive session. What personally we learned means that is, we don't know about what are the online resources are available to make use of active learning in a regular, that is in conventional classroom sessions. Personally, we would like to feel about how to create the online resource material and how to use the Word, that is WordPress. Yesterday we learned about the particularly about wiki spaces. It was quite interest. Actually, that is before we came into this workshop, we don't know about it. So for that, that is, we would like to thank you, sir. And suggestion for SWS, that is regarding peer assessment, it was already adjusted by some other. So we, that is personally, we, that is I, that we didn't go into that one. What we feel about that, we didn't get the clear explanation about how to match the rubrics, which was given by the some that is peer members. So that is the only thing that we have faced a lot of. And one more suggestion from our side is, please plan these type of sessions during the month of December to Jan. Then it will be helpful for us to actively take part in it. Why? Because it is now, that is, we are at the end of the university, that is end of the semester. We are asked to complete the syllabus, and most probably we are also having the university lab practicals. So by considering this, if it will be conducting during the month of December to January or during the month of May, like that, almost all of the participants, they will be taken part effectively, sir. So thank you for the opportunity.
Sir, another question. Sir, thank you for first and foremost, I thank the IIT Bombay for providing such a wonderful workshop for us. And thank you for special thanks for you for your interactive session, sir. And my question is regarding the peer review, sir. So is there is any online tool is available for peer reviewing, sir? So we also face the same problem which has been asked by the earlier participants, that is, we are belongs to some particular domain and the review which we done is belongs to another domain. So we are not been aware about that. So is there is any common special tools, online tool has been available for the to which overcome these kind of problems, sir?
Okay. So the one open-ended question that is there for all participants is, are participants aware of peer review tools, online tools, where it could be much more robust and much more, so there will be matching of domains and other things like that, isn't it, sir? Okay, yeah, that's, yes, okay. So I am keeping this question open, and thank you for the feedback that you have provided. So yes, we will definitely consider the timelines while we are releasing the next edition of these particular FDPs. Let me now go to 1098 Marathwada Institute of Technology, Aurangabad. So Marathwada Institute, I am actually reading the feedback that you have posted in chat. This FDP is different by itself as it focused on learning by doing, and there were so many new technologies, and the way in which it has been provided is has been much more effective, interesting, and fun feeling. Thank you for the feedback. If there are any questions, kindly post it. I will take it towards the end. I'll take the question towards the end. Kindly post the question in the chat. Let me now go to one more RC. RC 1108, RC Patel Institute.
Yes, from RC, we would like to thank IIT Bombay for providing such a great FDP. Because one thing we want to clear, that after 10 years, 12 years or 15 years of experience in teaching, the things get stuck and interest in teaching goes down day by day. Because we don't have anything new, or we are not doing anything new. But by following FDP, this 101 and 102, actually we have broken the barriers. And we know what new can we do in this teaching. I would like to thanks again. And one thing regarding peer review, as one of the ma'am has said from one of the RC, that if one follows the rubrics appropriately, then that domain bias is not the matter, because we don't have to check subject contents or like that. So I think if one follows the rubrics appropriately, then assessment is appropriate. that we want to say.
Yeah, thank you. Do you have any open questions for other participants?
Yes, one question.
Yeah.
Sir, this is not a question, but there is a request from our side. Like in next week, we will have vacations for Diwali. And during those vacation, since I am from a village, I have a problem of internet connectivity and all. So I cannot do my work from my village or my native place. So it's my request that if you will extend the dates by one more week, then we can come back to our working place and do the remaining work.
Yeah. So the request is taken. So we will definitely consider. We know that it is Diwali and everyone has to go to their homes for Diwali. We do understand that. Do not worry. So as Professor Fatak said, do not worry about the due dates or other things. We will make sure that you get sufficient time to do the activity, because the major part of it is the learning aspect of which needs to be done. And so by this 12th, all the learning element or the videos, releases, etc. would get over. And you will get sufficient time to prepare your OER, do the peer review, because that is very important in this FDP. So we will definitely consider that. And thank you for the feedback and specific input that it has actually broken the barrier of disinterest towards teaching learning. So this is we are very delighted that our small efforts could bring such huge changes and attitude shifts in your own practice. So we really thank you from deepest of our heart. Thank you, RC 1108.
Krishna, one technical question. Actually, what is happening since 8 to 10 days, I am not able to operate my discussion tab in account. Means I am not able to open a discussion forum.
Okay.
Everything else is fine. I am able to watch courseware and everything. Progress I can open, but discussion forum is the problem. I am getting one message that server error 1000 or 500 like that.
Okay. Yeah. So regarding the discussion error, it could be a technical issue. One thing that we would suggest is log out, clear your cache, and then try to log in again. That some people have observed that it actually worked for them. So it is actually a very random error, which we are actually trying to figure out why this is happening. Even our technical team is not able to figure out why this is happening, because it is happening one in maybe 10,000 or 20,000. This error is happening. So it's not just the FDP that is going on in IIT Bombay X right now. So there is a campus to corporate program which has around 30,000 students registered in IIT Bombay. So at the same time, we are handling around 30 to 40,000 learners in the same platform, and it is happening one in 10,000, one in 5,000, things like that. So our technical team is working on this. One advice that I got from several other participants who are trying this out is that once they logged out, cleared the browser cache, they found that discussion forums were coming up. So you may want to try that once.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Let me now go to RC 1192.
Sir, I just want to first thanks IIT Bombay for creating such wonderful activity for us, sir.
Yeah.
I also talked to you yesterday about this topic for RCA1, and now I'm going to talk with this RCA2, sir. This is my kind request to you that, sir, we as a member of all RC members, RCA2 assignment done by the peers is not by the many peers is not correct. Many a participant for our RC has done the activity correctly, but there were no assessed properly, and due to this work get suffered, and hence we request you to give the justice, sir. And from my side, I have given this RCA2, I have done all the job instructions for this RCA2, and I have just received very hard rash reviews from that, sir. Even though I have just followed all the instructions which is given by you, and I have followed them, sir. Today I am very demoralized, sir, to do the activities and all the things, but still I'm just I just want some thing from you, that is there any possible for the third party assessment from your side, that we have done this work very genuinely, sir. We are taking time from our day-to-day teaching activities and all the span, sir, and we are giving extra things. And one of my colleague from this RC is getting zero marks, even though he is giving total learning objectives, video length, and we have take n number of considerations from preparing this video, sir. So I feel that it is not justification to our work, sir. Yesterday also I have requested to you for RCA1, and again I am just giving RCA2 request for you, sir. Please consider. Okay. This is my first question, sir. And second question is about OER. OER. So as a group of team member, can we do this? Can we do this individually? Inform the mentor or group leader to inform this OER activity.
Okay. So regarding OER, each of you can individually inform your mentor. That is not an issue. I mean, you should actually inform the mentor. If you have formed across cohorts, then the mentor should be informed. I will come to the first RCA query in a short while. There are around 5 or 6 RCs now who have raised their hand. I'll answer them. So RC1282, Ishwar College of Engineering. Is there anyone?
Sir, the first they said that we have different profiles, different departments. How we can review the slides? I have a doubt. In remote centers, we have different peoples who are working for this FDP. We can communicate with each other and we can assess the pre-review. This is my suggestion for that particular review process.
Are there any other questions, open questions for other RCs to answer?
Sir, regarding Wiki, I have a doubt. Okay. Wiki spaces, we have created the website, Wiki space of our IIT Bombay X and remote center with the name. Then I have included our remote center persons to the mail ID and link. After that, what we have to do for Wiki?
Okay, so I'll answer this towards the end of this session, because I have like four or five things in the procedure list that is there. So I'll definitely answer this, and thank you for the feedback that you have provided, and for the suggestion about
One more feedback, sir. You have given the flipped class activity with your presentation slide, your slide. That is very useful for us for creating the flipped class activity. Same way you can give the elaborately for OER creation.
Okay. Yes. So thank you, RC1282. I will definitely try to generate one more PPT for the OER activity. So in fact, the PPT for OER activity is already there. The videos actually speak of it, and OER guidelines is the same feedback that we have provided. But I'll try to do one more clarification, screencast, and upload in YouTube. Thank you, RC1282. Let me now go to RC1211. Sri Shanmuga College of Engineering, Salem.
Sir, we would like to take this opportunity to thank the IIT team for giving us such a wonderful platform to learn these many ICT techniques. And we are really looking forward for courses like this. Though we have a bit disappointment regarding the evaluation, we are looking forward for your kind of solution for us. And thank you for giving us such a wonderful platform. And also, we would like to be part of that mentoring group which Fatek sir has already installed. Thank you, sir.
Okay, great. And thank you for your feedback. And we hope that all of you as an RC will continue working earnestly in creation of resources and will participate, collaborate with other participants in different RCs and with your cohort members in the coming days. Thank you, RC1211. Let me now go to RC1065, Phenolex Academy.
I just first of all like to thank the whole team of IIT Bombay for a wonderful learning experience through this workshop, and most important, bringing collaboration among the faculty members through interactive sessions. That's one thing. And second thing, I would like to appreciate two important points of this workshop. Number one is the faculty learn many of the outcome-based active learning strategies which will enhance the learning experience of the students definitely in the class. And the second thing that it made, it enabled them to learn the new ICT technologies beyond PowerPoint. We are used to of using PowerPoint in the classrooms, but I think through this we got to know number of platforms that can be used in the teaching learning, day-to-day teaching learning. There are a few questions on my part. This one is, yesterday you talked about creating a RC wiki page, sir, and we are still waiting for the guidelines, brief guidelines for creating of this wiki page. And second thing is, as number of the participants, they are talking about the problems in the evaluation. Like some members talked about sharing video link, and the evaluators are not even opening it, and they're just marking without opening the link of the videos that are shared. Not even marking, they said that the link doesn't exist. So I would request to all the evaluators to make sure you at least copy paste and open and check whether the content is created or not. Second thing is about why the Moodle was not used by IIT Bombay this time for the evaluation, because I think that makes evaluation quite easier, because all the things are in the same platform, that is the IIT Bombay X dashboard, I guess. Okay, that's one question. The second question from my side. So there is one more question from the another participant. I'd like to just say thank you for the wonderful learning experience.
Sure. Thank you.
I wanted to know the exact OER resources. We have to create one single resource or two small resources in the OER activity.
Okay, great. So the procedural aspect of it, I'll come back to around 5:15. I have like 3 or 4 RCs whose hand raises I have to address. After that, I'll come to the procedural aspect of both wiki activity as well as the OER activity. Regarding your question on why not Moodle, because we do not have a single sign-on functionality between IIT Bombay X and the Moodle. So when there are two different platforms handling different logins, different passwords, it was found to be more cumbersome for the participants, because we had tried this out in the last FDP, and many people had complained about two different interfaces. Though I completely agree that peer review in Moodle is much more straightforward and much more easier process.
That's true, sir. I too felt that, like, this people talking about the issues in the evaluation, especially assigning of the assignments in different domains, that could have been sorted out with the Moodle, I guess.
Yes, please go ahead.
What is expected in OER documentation?
Okay. I'll address all these procedural questions towards the end of at 5:15. Thank you, RC1065, for the feedback that you have provided. I'll address all these procedural questions that you had towards the end of the session. Let me now go to RC103.
Sir, we have done some measurement. We have implemented in our classroom, and that measurement I am going to share, sir. I have done this all exercise for our SE students. There are 68 students in the class. 47 students are actively engaged. Sir, we have devised a method called as before class, during class and after class. Before class, sir, we are sharing Wikipedia, YouTube, screencast and LXTs. 32% students are doing this activity regularly. And in class, sir, the course journal is most effective. Course journal is 85% students are doing regularly. Reflection spot is 72%. Flip class, 76.4% of the students are doing regularly, and probably TPS, that 52% was the engagement. So all these students who are actually engaged, we have given them makeup class attendance of extra 10%, so that they will do all the activities more effectively, sir. And after class, sir, after class we are asking the students to form groups and view their learning outcomes in my WordPress website. Sir, I'm very happy to tell you that 92% of the students are doing this activity regularly. Sir, that's why the unit test results that we also checked, that is improved by 32%. And also, sir, 28 students are active learners and they are with me on even on Sundays. So today also all our students are doing activities for that solving gate examination and IAS examination question papers in the Moodle. So thank you very much for this. And I must tell you, sir, that the overall improvement in my class is around 72% because of all the activities that has been showcased here. Thank you very much for this FDP.
Yeah, first of all, I should thank you for providing such a elaborate explanation with data. Provide such a big explanation in one shot. What I would also request you is, can you just document this and send it to me personally so that
yes.
I can actually, because I have certain questions. I'll measurement metric is using Moodle, right?
Measurement metric is seeing the engagement, how many students are actually engaged, and they are giving me the question papers also. And also, sir, I have taken some pictures as well.
So what this RC providing you is actually the next step that we want each one of you to look at when you actually assess what is happening in your class when you bring in these changes. And this is the way in which you can review your own practice and you can bring in more improvement. So only when you get a feedback, for example, I knew that 30% of my faculty participants are having problem with the peer review. Then I know that there is something wrong with the peer review. That is then I will go and look at what is happening in the peer review. Maybe I'll improve the rubric. Maybe I'll give you more suggestions, etc., etc. So what I would request the participant from RC1063 is please do send this in a documented format to me. I have a lot of questions for you, but what this example shows is it is actually possible to measure many of these things, and I will hopefully post all our interaction in the course so that other participants can also see what is how these different metrics are calculated. I would also encourage you to post this in the discussion forum, upload this document in your WordPress website in Creative Commons, and post that link in discussion forum with the title that how to measure. Shastra University.
I would like to thank you very much for the FTP program you have given us so far.
Okay.
I have learned so many ICT tools which I was unaware of. So I truly laud IIT Bombay X for giving us such a wonderful program. Now, sir, I have a few questions which I would like to know for the upcoming weeks regarding the OER submission. So you have given us an example OER document, but a template which can be edited has not been given. If we have a template where we can just make the changes for our OER submission alone, it would help us a lot. Because due to lack of time, we cannot sit and type the entire document and make the submission. That is my first query, sir. The second query is, I think earlier you had said that the team leaders will be given a link for uploading the OER documents.
Yes.
When will we come to know of that?
Okay.
And
I'm coming to the, so this is the procedural aspect of OER. I will be coming to you it in another 2-3 minutes. I'll just address the other queries from other RCs and I'll come to it.
Just one more question, sir. Did you face in your previous FDP any issues regarding peer assessment like we have now? And if so,
yes.
How did you solve it earlier? That is okay. Just for general information,
so,
sir.
This I am leaving out to the mentors on how they solved the peer review problem per se. No, the specific thing was last time there were issues. So if you look at the numbers in terms of percentages, the issue that is that has been reported in this FDP and the last FDP is approximately same, around 10. So at least in this FDP, I'm seeing lesser number of peer assessment worries than the last FDP. If you actually look at the volume, the number of peer assessment queries are less compared to the last FDP, and your mentors would vouch for it because they were also in the receiving end of the FDP, the peer assessment. Thank you for the feedback that you have provided. I'll address all the queries regarding the procedural aspect in a short while.
Thank you.
Let me now go to Dr. Mahalingam College, RC1235.
Sir, this is feedback from RC1235 Mahalingam College. First of all, we would like to thank Badak sir, IIT Bombay, your team members, particularly special thanks for you. We have learned a lot of different lab activities and the different sessions. Really, we are very happy to thank IIT Bombay. This is my request for you. Sir, month of August, September, October, last 3 months, you have conducted 3 different sessions. So, can you conduct only Saturday, month of every month, can you conduct 2 Saturdays except Sundays? Is it possible to conduct next year to be OTP? So this is for the useful for all, sir.
I will put this word to Professor Patak, who said that faculty are free Saturday and Sunday.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Sir. So please, one more feedback from our participants.
Sure.
Sir, thank you for making a paradigm shift in our teaching learning process, sir. Thank you, IIT Bombay, for becoming the Brahmas in creating 21st century teachers. And feedback I would like to receive from RCs about their, I want them to share the views about using MOOCs in curriculums. In our, being an autonomous college, how to incorporate MOOCs in our curriculum. This is the first point. Second point is about peer assessment rubrics. It was well addressed today. We want more clarity in that, sir. And the entire 2 FDP programs were successful. All the objectives are attained. Thank you very much, sir. Nandri, sir. Nandri.
Yeah.
Thank you.
The last 2 RCs, RC1135, Periyar Maniammai University, Tanjavur.
Yes, sir. Hello, sir. Since we have so many problems with the peer assessment, can you just take the number of activities that you participated in to assess us instead of having 50% cutoff?
Okay, I will definitely consider this request, but I'll address the the queries regarding peer assessment in another 2 minutes, because there are 2 more RCs who have queries. I'll come to the procedural aspect of peer assessment.
Just
in a
one
short
more, one
time.
More.
Is there any other question?
First of all, I would like to thank you for this wonderful FDP training program. We could learn a lot of things related to ICT. Yeah, it's a request from our side to have an option to resubmit this RCA2. Because many are there who lose their marks because of one poor peer assessment, and other is we need to improve our submitted material.
Okay, I'll address this in my procedural thing in a minute. Thank you, RC, for your feedback. Okay, so the first and foremost procedural aspect of it, in case of wrong peer assessment, what to do? So this is exactly why you have your mentors. So mentors is your second reviewer who will assess your submissions, both RCA1. So wherever you have found problems, so this is a general guideline for all the mentors also. What you should do is you should consolidate all these problems, and you should be reviewing the mentee's submission and providing your feedback about it. And we'll be taking that and factoring in final grading of FDP201, rather than just relying on the peer assessments from the IIT Bombay X alone. There are multiple issues over here. So one is that somebody was not able to get another peer's submission to review, or somebody has not been reviewed at all. So all these kind of peer review issues, you should take in, all these should be emailed to your mentor. And the mentor will be reviewing it and providing us with the their feedback. So their review will be provided to us. What we are going to do is we are going to send out an email to all mentors telling about the and consolidating all this from the mentors, where they can actually do it in an Excel sheet. So the mentee's name, so each assignment RCA1 or RCA2 can be one sheet in that Excel sheet, and they can actually mark it as per the criteria. So for each criteria will become a column in the sheet, and the mentee's name will be the rows. So all the mentors will have, let's say 10 of your mentees had problem. So in RCA1, so in sheet 1, you can write the category name as RC1, and you can write the 10 mentees usernames and the criteria that you evaluate and give your mark. And you should put one comment over there, why this problem has happened. So what was the problem in the peer review? You can comment over there. There are some cases where the original submission was incorrect, wherein somebody has provided a WordPress dashboard link instead of the specific page link. So whenever a reviewer actually looks into a dashboard which requires user ID and password, he's unable to get that. So it is not an incorrect review. It is a problem with an incorrect submission. So all these should be alerted. What we are recommending is, we may, in case of incorrect submissions, we may do a small penalty, which we will let you know. So for example, RCA 2 is out of 12. And if somebody has put in a wrong submission link, we will do a 1-point penalty just for an incorrect submission, where we had provided clear instruction as to what has to be submitted, and somebody has not followed that or has not understood that, we will bring in a 1-point penalty from our side. And we will look at the mentor's review and your peer review assessment, and based on that only the final grading will be done. So we will look at the marks, and we will look at the best of these will be provided to you. The same holds for any of the RCAs which has the problem. Okay, so mentor's job, one thing that you have to mention is, if in case there is a problematic problem in submission, they should indicate that in the Excel sheet. Do not worry if you haven't understood it. For all mentors, I'm going to send out an email. A form will be prepared and will be sent to you by end of this week. So by Friday evening, all the mentors will receive this form. You can consolidate all your mentees peer review queries by that time and submit in the form. So all the participants are requested to send out all your queries to the mentors. Now here again, we have another issue that has been pointed out by several mentees. So here what we have seen is that some mentors are not very active. In this case, what we will request all the, so we are going to anyway send a feedback form regarding the mentor-mentee participation to each participant separately, which is an anonymous survey. What we would like is, so all the mentees know the corresponding cohort members. So what you can actually do is, if you know an active mentor, you can send out an email to e-outreach mentioning that my mentor is inactive. You can put your cohort number and send out an email to e-outreach by Tuesday evening. So what we'll do is, we will allot you to a different mentor who is active. So when once you have a new mentor, you can send your peer review problems to this new mentor, who will evaluate it and provide us the feedback. So if the mentor is inactive, please send an email by Tuesday evening to us so that we can allot you to a new mentor. So this is regarding RCA 2 and RCA 1. I hope all of you have understood this clarification. Regarding OERs, please do not worry about due dates. We also know that the upcoming weeks, there are a lot of holidays and a lot of delays. So we will definitely ensure that you get at least 10 to 12 active days for submission and another 8 to 10 active days for review. Regarding the guidelines, we have only one OER guideline that was provided to you in the IIT Bombay X courseware. Please do visit the web pages of your mentors or other mentors. We had actually put this list in FDP 101. all these mentors have created OERs. So if you want to see a diverse set of OERs, what could work, what will not work, etc., you can actually go and see these mentors' WordPress web pages. Here the guideline document is also very clearly written. And regarding template for guideline document, so the title and other thing is all the beautification aspect. All you have to focus is on the chapter headings and the key content that is inside. So any format would be acceptable as long as it adheres to the chapter goal and the chapter name is the same and it adheres to the chapter goal. So I think you should put some effort in writing down all these aspects, because logging and documentation is an equally important task as compared to also to creation. And you can actually copy paste from PDF given. I think Word will accept a lot of this. So only thing is you will have to spend some time on formatting the document. Regarding lab 2, please go and visit. So what I'll do is I'll just do a desktop sharing. So if you actually look in your course handouts, if you look at the session 7th October, session 3, this is the PDF. And from session slide number 11 to 12, here I have provided clear instruction on what you have to do as wiki activities. So the objective is to elicit the best practices followed by participants with regards to integration of MOOCs in their regular teaching learning practice and encouraging knowledge sharing across several institutions. So within your RC, you will have to create a wiki spaces. You will have to ensure that all the participants in the RC is enrolled in this wiki. Each participant should have a page within your wiki. So each participant and each of these pages should be linked to the main page. So everyone should create one page. Every participant should create one page. And how to link that to the main page? There is a widgets feature called list of pages. I would like you to explore wiki spaces and see how this widget feature is coming over there. And instructions for wiki activity for participants. This is the page that you have to create. The subject or courses that you are taking in the current semester or in the next academic semester. MOOCs that you have participated in. So it could be a MOOC that you have learned. It could be a Coursera MOOC. It could be an edX MOOC. It could be an NPTEL MOOC. So any massive open online course that you have already attended, you can provide the details over here. And you should mention the ways in which you have tried to incorporate this MOOC's content. It could be questions, it could be videos, it could be external links, etc. within your regular teaching learning practice. Suppose in case you have not registered for a MOOC, explore the MOOCs that are listed in this particular website, classcentral.com, and identify few courses that you will like to participate in. Then try to identify ways in which you can actually integrate them in your regular teaching learning practice. So you should write these two in the wiki page. Submission instructions. You don't have to submit it anywhere. All you have to do is please add this particular Gmail ID into your wiki. So this is the IIT Bombay team who is handling the FDP. We have a wiki space user with this particular registered email ID. Please add this email ID as a member in your wiki. Our team will be checking the wiki over the coming weeks and we'll be looking at the various practices. We'll be consolidating all of this into the main FDP ICT wiki. Now, regarding lab assignment, we are yet to release lab assignment 2, knowledge quiz 3, assimilation quiz 3, and reflection quiz 3. Within 2 days, we'll be uploading all these questions and we'll be releasing it. This time around, we'll be giving you 12 days to complete all these quizzes. Okay, so people who want to leave early for Diwali, you can complete the knowledge quizzes and these short quizzes early. And for people who want more time, there are 12 days for submission. Regarding OER activity, the workshop team is facing multiple issues because again, we see only yesterday we had only 3,090 participants who have submitted their names in the survey. So what they have done is they have reopened the survey. and they will be sharing the OER draft team list in IIT Bombay X tomorrow. Here also they are saying that there are multiple problems. So there are cases where one participant is present in more than two teams, or some teams have uneven structure. So one participant has entered, there are two members in my team, whereas his colleague has mentioned that I have three members in my team. So there are these inconsistencies. So what we are going to do is we are going to create a PDF and we are going to publish it in IIT Bombay X, where we'll upload. So by tomorrow evening, the team is going to consolidate all the responses that have come, and they are going to upload the team list in IIT Bombay X under course handout. What you have to do is, once you check this list and if your team strength is correct, there is no issues. But if there are some discrepancies in your team size or team names, please do inform e-outreach so that we can do appropriate corrections from our end. The survey has been reopened. We request all participants to complete the survey by tomorrow morning, 11 o'clock. We'll close the survey at 11 o'clock, and any request for reopening the link will not be entertained. Because see, 3000 participants have already submitted, and the OER submission instructions are getting delayed because of around 1500 participants who are not submitting their survey response. To all faculty participants who have already submitted the team information and have created the OER, we request you to be patient for some two more days. By Wednesday evening, clear instruction on how to submit OER and the submission links will be activated. So Wednesday evening around 10 o'clock, we'll be opening the OER submission link. We'll try to see that only the team leaders is going to submit in this particular submission link. The exact modalities will be known, because we need the team information to completely understand how many different varieties of domains have been taken. Are there any? So see, if we say that the number of reviewers is to be three, there should be minimum three teams in that particular domain. We have like 15 or 16 domains in OER grouping. And this time around, we are actually going to split it as per domain. So if somebody is selected civil, we will ensure that somebody else from civil is going to be their peer reviewer. So a lot of this domain related aspects will be featured in the OER. And hence, it is important for us to know whether we have sufficient strength in each domain, and whether we can actually split it up and provide sufficient instructions. So unless and until this information is available with us, we will not be able to proceed further. But what I will ensure is that you will get sufficient time for completing this activity as well as reviewing the activity. Because this is a mandatory assignment. OER creation is a mandatory resource creation assignment, without which you will not be certified for FDP201x. Let me repeat, without OER submission, you will not get certificate of FDP201, even if you have qualified as per the pass percentage. I hope I have addressed most of the procedural questions. Due dates, please do not worry. As Professor Fatak said, we will ensure that you get sufficient time. The groupings is also the same. And again, repeating, for peer assessment, please contact your mentor. Let him consolidate all the peer review crits so that he can assess them and submit to us from Friday. So you should be sending out your peer review problems. And while sending out the problems, please note that you have to send detailed screenshots. You should not just say that my peer review was problematic. It does not make sense to a... So consider your own case. When a student of yours come to you saying that their exam answer sheet has a problem, you ask them to show the exam sheet, right? So similarly, it is required that you provide screenshots of issues that you faced and give the mentor sufficient time for reviewing your submissions. And for people who are facing a problem of inactive mentor, please contact e-outreach at the earliest with the subject line. So we will move all the cohort members to a new mentor, maybe two or three different mentors, but we will try to ensure that all your queries get diverted to an active mentor, because there are several participants who are giving us personal feedback that their mentors are very active and they are providing very efficient support to them throughout this FDP. So I know that there is a large percentage of associate faculty who are dedicatedly doing their task, and there are few aberrations that we came to know about, but please do not worry about it. We are going to take care. We know that how important this is, and the larger mission is to bring in more collaboration and support from the community. So I hope I have addressed all your queries. I take this opportunity to thank all the participants who have come on a Sunday. I will definitely put this word to Professor Fatak, saying that at least participants have requested at least one day off in the synchronous interactions. My video team will also be happy knowing that participants themselves have requested for a Sunday off. So video team, sorry for the 8-minute delay. At IIT Bombay, we have our studio team, the workshop team and content team, who are the back end of such a large initiative. I thank all of them. I also thank Professor Sridhar, Professor Sahanamurthy, and Professor Fatak. So Professor Fatak went to Calcutta today. I believe that he suffered all the flights in Mumbai were delayed for 1.5 hours in the morning due to a runway issue. Even I faced the same issue today morning. So I hope that he would have addressed you at a later point of time. He was supposed to come at around 10 o'clock. I thank Professor Fatak, first of all, for the large initiative that he has given us, the opportunity that he has given people like me and you to be part of a larger initiative take it forward further. I also thank the participants in Amal Jyoti College RC1002 who are still waiting for me to stop the lecture. Thank you from